Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijjar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And as I have stated earlier, the chosen people, they are special people. They are the demonstration nation of the world. And through them, we learn moral laws. And they also tell us if there is trouble coming up in the world. Now, the chosen people have been given a special land called Promised Land, and Promised Land belonged to Abraham. Whenever they are faithful to Abraham, they get the best fruit in the world. Nothing can beat them. The land is fertile, and you can live lavishly. That is what Christ Jesus told in the parable of the prodigal son. The prodigal son is Isaac, the younger one. The elder one is Ishmael, the Arab people. Now, whenever the people of Isaac, the chosen people, they become unfaithful to Abraham, they become Jews of the physical self, because Abraham was not a Jew. He was Semitic, some Semite race. So physically he was of Semite and not a Jew or any other, you know. So whenever they become Jews of the physical self, then their covenant with Abraham is severed. And when they sweared, then they have no right to live in that promised land. The same promised land become barren and they have to leave it. And last time they left it for Egypt, and over there they suffered and they were treated as with the luxury they were enjoying over there. They were treated like pigs in Egypt. So Moses brought them back and they ate manna as a food of repentance. So 40 years they were in the wilderness and they survived on manna. That means it is not the will of the man that a person dies, it is the will of our Father that a person dies. Lives. So they survived the very poor food, and then they entered into the promised land. And when they entered the same promised land, which was barren, to their surprise, it was lush green, full of fruit and everything. So that is called when the father Abraham saw his son Isaac coming, the people Isaac, he greeted them with a fattened calf. Now, most people, when I go to these theological meetings in Oxford, they have no idea who is this prodigal son. They say, oh, his name is not mentioned there, so how do we know? I said, that's why they are called parable, and you have been poisoned by the Old Testament. Old Testament is old wine. And when you get drunk with the old wine, then you desire not the new. So if you don't drink the old wine, then you think about these parables, then you dig them out. But if you are drunk with the old wine, you always like to read everything by letters. What is written, what is underneath the trails, you can't find them. Same, you know, this whole story of Genesis is mentioned by Jesus or summarized by Jesus in one sentence. Every plant which my heavenly Father plant means the person, Heavenly Father means Yahweh, that every plant which my Heavenly Father Yahweh did not plant, that means who has lost his tribal identity, will be uprooted by the roots, will be killed by the roots, by the supporters. Now I was in Africa. Over there, you know, the people, to keep their tribal identity intact, they have tribal marks over their face. From the face, you can identify this man belongs to this tribe, that belongs to this tribe. So they are the plant planted by our Heavenly Father. So they will not die. They will survive this atomic war. And if there is a war among them, you know, that also doesn't last long, because the sectarian roots do not hold root there because of the tribal identity. Wherever people are sons of man, over there, you know, Satan can't work. Satan works where there is no sons of man, such as in Britain and other people, where they have lost their tribal identity, there the Satan works. And where the Satan works, then there you have this disparity of wealth. Some are very rich, some are very poor. Remember, the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, was he a rich man? He was a poor, but his heart was rich. Whereas a Jew who was rich, and when he asked Jesus how to become perfect, he said, give those riches which you have fleeced the poor back to the poor and you will be perfect. But he had the love of mammon, so he pulled a long face and went away. So the people who have love of mammon, they are sons of Satan. You will find them that they are crook, you know, and time has come to sort them up. And that's where the countries where there is a disparity of wealth, you will see riots coming up. As in London, people are camping at St. Paul's Cathedral, ready for the riots. In other countries also, the same thing. Unemployment will go up, riots will go up, and so will be the disturbance. So this, what's happening in the Middle East, is all clear to everyone. And soon the culprit will be known, who is instigating all that trouble, or who is causing all those problems. Then that people will go for him and they will kill him, as they did in 66 AD, when they killed Jesus, killed Stephen and Saint James the Just. Then the Jews in the villages were killed, old and young, everyone. And they ran to Jerusalem for safety. Roman besieged them and killed them. Same bundling up is going to take place in Israel. People will be rushing to Israel, and when you see them rushing, then you can think that the atomic war is not far away. It's just on the threshold. So we are very lucky to see this last days, and this is our very golden chance to preach gospel, to fish the men. We cannot fish the women. Now, men are those who are masters of their own destiny. As in John 9, the born blind person, he gave the answers from his own heart. He didn't ask his parent what to say, and his parents were quite open-minded. They were not frightened of those hypocrite Pharisees and Sadducees. So No wonder he was thrown out of the synagogue. Same, Jesus cured 10 lepers, and 9 of them was Jews. As soon as they were cured, they rushed towards their synagogue and sat over there with a stiff neck like monkeys sitting there. Whereas the Gentile who was uncured, he accompanied Jesus. He gave him company and learned from him gospel as the Samaritan woman at well in John 4. She was very knowledgeable person that she engaged Jesus in deep discussion, and by vetting him, she declared that you are a prophet. And the Jews, they hate Samaritan. They hate the light. And what they call her? That she was marrying one husband after the other. Bad woman. And the Western theologian, they are blind, spiritually blind. As I told you, none of these theologians in Oxford knows who created Adam and Eve. Can you find anything simpler question than that? And they will never ask me, because this answer to this problem, simple question, you can't get it unless God give you the common sense to do so. But when they are drunk with the old wine of the letters, then the common sense flies away, runs away. So there's no common sense among them. So no answer. So it's quite amazing, or amusing rather, that how these theologians, they read books, they get degrees, doctorate, this and that, but simple question they can't answer. So we are in tribulation period, and atomic war could take place end of next year. And let's see what happens. Now this America and Britain or other, which are the Jewish colonies, mammon master rules, money makes the mayor go. So they will be helping Israel to attack a country making atomic bomb. That could be Iran or any other country. Once that happens, then you will see that how the people will split into pro-Russia and pro-America. And then we are ready for the atomic war. Our Father God blesses you.